mid or the medium wave, I think that was the zero. And again, you can identify those substances because typically they are pure white, because they detect like a cloud or this camera density. And you also know why this happens. This is because of the irregularity in the video. That leads to the fact that the incoming laser beam, the different penetrating into the camera, will be scattered, and the scattering will be scattered to determine. So all of the types of components are scattered and get back reflected, and this is exactly what we see in the background. The question says a lot of backscattering is also used for the light that is trying to get through, as we saw in the video, to be encountered. This is the kind of bare law that leads to the exponential.
Rather simple, you take a green laser like this, you time it on a focus based on the light modulator or the SMM, which is similar to the light modulator of the video projector, only that it fits the array, it doesn't change the color, but it fits actually the wavefront, which is the pixel, like the 15 and the 24. In this way, you can take the wavefront of the laser that's reflected on the SMM, you can send it to the sugar or powder, and then you record the speckle pattern, which is the time interferometric pattern with blood. And from the speckle pattern here, you can view what the complex numbers in this higher dimensional spectrum are. Once you have it, then you can relate any incoming field on that side to any outgoing field. So to any outgoing field on the other side. So what can you now do with the stratus flow of information that you store in this? First of all, we can do actually many things that people dreamt about many years ago, but didn't realize, for example, in microscopic physics, where you can study, for example, how electrons propagate at very low temperatures through a conductor, which is typically disordered. And people, like in the 80s, Ulrich and others, they looked at this problem from a mathematical point of view.
having this matrix model, and then ask themselves if I make some statistical assumptions about the transmission matrix, what would I find? And I started the transmission across this medium, which could then be measured by the conductor. So for this, they didn't look at the transmission matrix, but they looked typically at the specialty beta T, which is a transmission matrix. The singular values of T are related, of course, to the eigen values of T beta T, that's a square. And this T here is the transmission eigen value, which can vary between 0 and 1. You have minimum transmission 0 or maximum transmission 1. And the corresponding eigenstate for the first transmission would be certain wavefronts coming in here. And when they look at the distribution of transmission eigenvalues, they found something really interesting. They found that most of the most of the transmission is actually close to zero, meaning that those wavefronts that you send in, they just get backscattered, they are transmitted to the other side. But what they found is that there are also open transmission channels. Very close to one. This means that even for a very, very complex system that's cutting a lot, you can find states with a corresponding incoming wavefront, corresponding to a transmission eigenvalue close to one, that this with the property that this wavefront will go through the system of the medium with full completion of the reflection. Isn't that amazing that this can work? Here you have a maze of this order. You send the wave in the right way, you will be fully transmitted. So here this was just a theoretical model. It was just an info also realized. This experiment, in the first experiment that we've done here, this context was in the group of electrons and green, using not electrons, not light, but in this case acoustic waves. These are length waves that propagate in this aluminum strip, and to simulate or to image the disorder we took from both in this place, and excited those waves to the laser and could measure them. In this case, could actually experimentally at the time measure the transmission matrix and looked at the statistics. And what he found is that with the exponential perfection, we got the primordial distribution, but also showing some transmission values larger than 1, which is of course realistic, due to some exponential perfections. With some corrections included, enforcing the unitarity of the scattering matrix, we could indeed see the boundary distribution, which is now inside the order that the measure in the optics, and I think I like to speak to the fact about the open transmission. Another interesting property of those states of light that make it across with medium is that as compared to a random wavefront, this is now this part of the tendency from the top, where you have acoustic waves trying to propagate through this disorder. The open transmission eigenchannels, as you can see here, they build up much more intensity in the inside of the medium. And this tells you that most states of sound or of light that are fully transmitted, they do not just go through like a ballistic photon or ballistic wave. This is actually an interferometric effect. They go in there, they reverberate a lot, build up intensity, but then they interfere constructively on the right hand side to be transmitted, and constructively on the left hand side to be transmitted. So this is how those waves manage to find the exit on this. Another interesting thing that you can look at is not just the transmission, but you can also use the transmission matrix. You can ask yourself the question, if I program my space light modulator, now it's going to be a laser, that produces an image on the screen, propagating through the space, is it possible that there are, that I can program my space light modulator in such a way, that this image will also remain if I put a stronger scattering slab in between these space light modulators. the question we addressed together with color a few years ago. And once you have the transmission and the proportion here, this is a problem that can be solved. Let me show you how. So first of all, you need the transmission matrix to square. What is the transmission matrix between the space light modulator and the screen? Well, this is not a trivial matrix like one, because from the SLM to the screen, you will achieve all the phase, and the phase information should be included in the SLM. Then you also can also measure the transmission matrix of the medium. Then you can say, okay, have both of those equations, and they work for all incoming fields whatsoever. But now I'm looking at very special incoming fields that have the property that they will go through the disordered medium to produce some output field in the same way as when I inject those states to the air. The only difference is that I have a global factor here in front.